What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English bit. In today's lesson, we're going to learn 20 French words that are used in English. They are usually pronounced in a way close to their French pronunciation. Are you ready to expand your vocabulary? So take a notebook and let's kick off. The first French word we're going to learn today is café. The British pronunciation is café and the stress goes on the first syllable, café. While the American pronunciation is café with the stress at the end, café. So café or café. For example, I like having a drink in a nice café. To tell the truth, also a piece of cake. Let's move on to our second word, which is ballet. The same, British English, the stress goes on the first syllable, ballet, American at the end, ballet. So ballet or ballet. For example, she's an amazing ballet dancer. Let's continue. Number three, croissant. Here, the pronunciation is very different if it's British or American. British, croissant, croissant, and American, croissant, croissant. So, croissant or croissant. For example, I bought some croissants on my way home. Let's continue. Number four, cuisine. The stress goes at the end and the last E is long. Cuisine, cuisine. For example, I'm a Japanese cuisine lover. And you? Number five, déco, British, déco. The stress goes on the first syllable, déco. And American, the stress goes at the end and the sound is day, décor, décor. British, déco, or American, décor. For example, this restaurant's décor is so stylish. Restaurant is another French word, a bonus. Number six, souvenir. Souvenir. L'on ou, sous, and the stress goes at the end. Souvenir. Souvenir. For example, I don't like tacky souvenirs. Let's move on to number seven, bouquet. Bouquet. The pronunciation, l'on ou, bou, and the stress goes at the end. Bouquet. Bouquet. For example, he gave her a gorgeous bouquet of flowers for her birthday. Number eight, genre. Genre. The pronunciation, l'on a, genre. Genre. For example, what's your favorite book genre? In my case, I like love stories. Let's continue. Number nine, au pair. Au pair. The stress goes on the second syllable. Au pair. Au pair. For example, she's working as an au pair in London now. Number 10, fiancé. The British pronunciation is fi-o with o and short e. Fiancé. And the American pronunciation is long e, fi, and then it's a. Fiancé. Fiancé. So British, fiancé, or American, fiancé. The tricky thing here is the spelling. If we talk about a man, it's spelled with one E at the end. If it's a woman, double E. But the pronunciation is exactly the same. Fiancé or fiancé. For example, I haven't met her fiancé yet. Number 11. Cliché, British, the same, the stress goes on the first syllable. Cliché, American, at the end. Cliché. It's level C2. Cliché or cliché. For example, it may sound a cliché, but I believe in true and unconditional love. Let's continue with a quite difficult word to pronounce. Number 12, entrepreneur. The British pronunciation is with O at the beginning and the stress at the end. Entre, entre, preneur, entrepreneur, and the American pronunciation at the beginning is long a. Entrepreneur, entrepreneur. It's somebody who starts their own business. For example, he's a very successful entrepreneur. Let's continue with another tricky word to pronounce. Raconteur. It's British. Raconteur. The stress goes at the end. And American, raconteur, with long A. Raconteur, American. So, raconteur or raconteur. And this word means somebody who is very good at telling anecdotes or stories. For example, my friend is a great raconteur. Let's move on to number 14. It's a word I like very much. Déjà vu. Déjà vu. The stress goes at the end and long U. Déjà vu. Déjà vu. It means a feeling of having experienced the present situation. For example, when I smelled that perfume, I had a strange feeling of déjà vu. Number 15, faux pas. Faux pas. The stress goes at the end and it's long A. Faux pas. And it means an embarrassing social mistake. For example, I realized I made a faux pas when I brought up the forbidden topic by mentioning her ex-husband. Let's continue. Number 16, blasé. Blasé. Pronunciation long A and the stress goes at the end. Blasé. Blasé. And it means bored and not excited. For example, as people get older, they usually become blasé about life. Let's continue. Number 17, nouveau riche. Nouveau riche. Pronunciation long U at the beginning, nu, and riche long E at the end. Nouveau riche. Nouveau riche. It means people from a low social class who have recently become rich and they want to show off and spend a lot of money. It's disapproving. For example, nouveau riche Russians love gold things. Let's move on to our adjective number 18. Avant-garde, British, avant-garde, or American, avant-garde. Avant-garde. It means people and ideas that are ahead of their time. It's a synonym of cutting edge. For example, the city has avant-garde architecture. Number 19, to sabotage. To sabotage, or American, sabotage. It means to intentionally prevent the success of a plan or action. It can be also a noun. For example, they will try to sabotage our campaign. And last but not least, to rendezvous, British with O, rendezvous, or American, rendezvous, with long A and long O, to rendezvous. And it means to meet somebody at a particular place and time. It can be also a noun, to have a rendezvous. For example, let's rendezvous at 5 p.m. tomorrow. So that's it for today. It's been a long lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to give it a like, to subscribe to the channel, and catch me on Instagram. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao for now.